He would be bringing up a service or a memorial or something in the way this is coming through. It felt like there was a rush in the way this came through, but after, and they keep bringing this up and they're having me talk about the timing.
Oh my God, I know exactly what that was.
But it didn't go the way it was planned.
You want me to tell you what it was? The worst day of my life to date, beyond the passing of my father, was the burial of my father. And in the Jewish religion, you go back to the house and you have a service.
Right.
And you sit Shiva. And you know who I am, I'm a germaphobe. And there was a series of events. My parents, I'll tell you a couple of them. The first one was some guy came and sat, he goes, people just come in, right? It's right. A flurry of people that come in. The first guy comes in and he goes, are you the son? And I said, yes. And he goes, I just want to tell you, I was a friend of your father and he was a wonderful man. I said, thank you. And he said, without him, he inspired me to go on and do whatever I did. And I said, well, thank you very much. I remember this vividly. And he said, whenever he sang, it just uplifted the whole room. And I go, when he sang, my father never sang. He goes, yeah, I saw him sing in Acapulco. I said, my father's never been to Acapulco, and he never sang in Acapulco. And then he said to me, is this the Goldstein funeral? No, he was at the wrong funeral. So he left, and that was kind of funny, but it was in the midst of the saddest day. And then the next thing that happened in the same day, another guy comes who is a friend of my father, somebody that I did know. And he was like tearing, and I was tearing, and he goes, this is such a terrible thing, but I just wanted to say. And right in the middle of a sentence, he rushes. He goes, I gotta go. And he runs out. And as he runs out, I think that he drops a candy or something. And I said, oh, you dropped it. And he just kept running.
Right.
And so I picked up the candy to try to get him, but he had gone.
Right.
And, but it wasn't a candy.
Oh no.
And he had a stomach disorder.
Gotcha.
And I picked up, and I thought it was a candy, and I went, oh my God, and I screamed.
No.
Like a little, yes, there was, it was poop.
Right.
And my mom screamed, and we're screaming, and she takes me into the bathroom, and she scalds my hand. You know, I won't shake hands, and now I have poop of a mourner on my hand, and she's pouring, like, alcohol, and I'm screaming, I'm going, help me, help me! And the people in the living room are just going, oh, this family is just in such pain for this loss. They have no idea that we're both just screaming because there's poop on my hand. But that the worst day of my life, it was laugh after laugh after ridiculous laugh. And these are not stories that I have shared publicly.
Right.
Now I have.
Right.
Oh my gosh.
Well, please know, I mean, I think the essence behind that was that he was okay with things being funny. And as hard as that was.
He really is. He always used to say, happens.
Exactly.
And it did.